Well friends, in previous lecture we have learned the lesson 100 dresses part 1 by A.L. Besser-Wester. So this is the continuous lesson of the part first. Already we have seen in the lesson how Vanda Petronsky got bullied by the classmate as well as a few of her best friends. And then whole episode we have learned in this lesson. So first of all, again we'll remind, again we'll revise the characters of the first part. You know that Vanda Petronsky, who has come from the Poland, and she was not native person of America, and that is why she was getting very ill treatment by her classmate. She was treated very indifference in her classmate, by her classmate. Then Peggy was the very smart girl in the class, who has a little great beauty. She has curly hair, and she was dominating girl in the class. Then Maddie was the best friend of Peggy, and so as Vanda Petronsky was very poor, little poor, like Maddie was also poor, so she was totally dependent on the Peggy, and she never raised her voice against the Peggy, even though Peggy was not good at her behavior. Then we know that one more character in the lesson, that is Miss Mason, was the class teacher of the room number 13 where all these kids were sitting together. Now today we are going to learn in the second part of the lesson, that is John Petronsky, who is the father of Vanda Petronsky, and Jake Petronsky, who is the brother of Vanda Petronsky. So what exactly happened in the first part of this lesson, the 100 dresses? That you see, Vanda was not native girl, she has come from the Poland, and that is why she has certain funny name which was not familiar for the American people, and that is why her classmates used to make fun of her, and that is why she was quite odd man out girl in the class. Then what happened, she had got very ill treatment by her, that is why she was not comfortable in the class. She used to shut her mouth all the time, she used to keep quiet, even though she was very quite clever girl in the class, but she had always kept mum, and she was sitting at the second last bench where certain notorious student used to sit. But she has preferred there to sit. Why? That already we have learned, that because she used to come from the very muddy area, and that is why her sandals were covered with the mud. Peggy used to ask her one question, how many dresses you have, because she knows very well knows the fact that she has only one dress. She used to wear it again and again, she used to clean it, and she used to use it. She never ironed that, because she belongs to a very poor family. That is why, to make fun of her, she used to ask her, how many dresses you have, and then she used to say, who? Vanda Petronsky used to say that I have 100 dresses in my closet. And after listening this answer, all the students used to, or all the classmates used to laugh on her, but she said nothing on that. That we have learned. And then she won. Then afterwards, after a while, Miss Mason, who conduct one competition contest, that girls have to draw the picture of dresses, and boys have to draw the picture of the motorboats. So that competition they have, Miss teacher have conducted in the class, and after that, Miss Vanda Petronsky never come to school. And when all were guessing that Peggy will win the contest, because she was smarter than anyone else in the class, and you know that she has made that dominance in the class, so everybody used to say that you will win the contest. But at the time of when they come in the school to see that who has drawn or who will win the contest, so that time, that day, this Peggy and Mary didn't wait for the Vanda Petronsky. Actually, they used to wait for her to make fun of her, because while coming from house to here, they used to get some time to make fun of her. So they used to wait for her, but that day they didn't wait for her. So when they come in the class, that time they saw that 100 sketches of, every sketch has a different extraordinariness was there. So everybody amazed with that. Who has drawn these 100 sketches? And after that, when result was announced, then it was given that Miss Vanda Petronsky won this contest. So even boys also amazed with the painting. And everybody was waiting for Wanda, even Miss Mason, who was a teacher of the room number 13, was waiting for her, but she didn't come. And this was the end of the first part of the lesson, that was 100 dresses part 1. Now we'll see what exactly given in the 100 dresses part 2. Was Miss will she come in the class again, or she has gone somewhere? What happened to Wanda Petrowski? We haven't known that. So now we will see what exactly happened to Wanda Petrowski in the part 2. So we'll see that while the class was circling the room, the monitor from the principal's office brought Miss Mason a note. Miss Mason read it several times and studied it thoughtfully for a while. Then she clapped her hands. And it was a very, you know, morning scenario in the class. All boys and girls were circling around table of teacher Miss Mason, and suddenly one boy came from the principal office, and he had certain note in his hand. And when Miss Mason has seen that note very carefully, she looks so sad and nervous. She was looking so what we can say, very anxious about the note. What exactly? And then she has seen at the class very thoughtfully. Then she clapped her hand to make all the students keep quiet. Attention class, everyone back to their seat. When the shuffling of feet had stopped and the room was still and quiet, Miss Mason said, "I have a letter from Wanda's father that I want to read to you." And then she waited till boys and girls make silence. So at last become quiet in the class. And then she announced very seriously that I have a letter from Wanda's father and I want to read for it to whole class. Miss Mason stood there a moment and the silence in the room grew tense and expectant. And after that she kept pause. She stopped for a while. Again everybody becomes so anxious, very excited, and it was expectant because Wanda was not coming. Even though she has won the contest, if we are there and if we happen to know that certain competition was there and I won the first prize, then next day we would have been waiting for the that day when I will join the school. But she didn't come, and that is why all the students of the class room number 13 were very eager to learn what exactly happened to Wanda, why she is not coming, and teacher has got the letter of Wanda's father. So everybody was very anxious and very eager to listen what exactly happened. The teacher adjusted her glasses slowly and deliberately. So here we can understand the seriousness of the problem. She has again adjusted her glasses, and very deliberately she had adjusted. So she should not miss a single word also. She should not miss a single student also who is listening. Her manner indicated that what was coming, this letter from Wanda's father, was a matter of great importance. And why she did that, all things, why she showed the seriousness? Because she wanted to convey that it is very, very serious matter. And it is very important matter for all of us. To me also, Miss Mason also, and as well as whole class. Everybody listen closely as Miss Mason read the brief note. We'll see what exactly Wanda's father has written in this note. "Dear teacher, my Wanda will not come to your school anymore. Jake also. Now we move away to big city. No more holler polar. No more ask why funny name. Plenty of funny names in the big city. Yours truly, John Petronsky." So letter was really very serious one. So by this letter, the father of Wanda has announced that his daughter is not going to come in the school again. Okay, we have learned that Wanda Petrowski was quite, silent in the class. Even though anybody would have teased her, she said none to them. It not means that she didn't hurt. She didn't got hurt. She hurt. She got hurt. But she never said. She might have told her to her parents. So the parents wanted to ship both of their kids to the big town where many people will be there. There will be other people who had different name. Why Wanda Petrowski was a funny name? Because in America it was very, you know, small settlement where this Wanda Petrowski is a quite different name, very funny name for, it was not usual name. But when they will move to big city, there will be different kinds of people will be living there. And so this particular name will be common there. So that he said that, so this will not be that now we move away to big city, no more holler or polak, means there will not be no big noise about the any particular small thing. No more ask why funny names, and plenty of funny names in the big city. That is why I am going there. So my daughter and my son will not get any torture from this Native American. So deep silence made the reading of lecture. Miss Maston took out of her glasses, blew on them, and wiped them on her soft white handkerchief. So it was very serious matter. That is why again she showed some seriousness. Teacher has shown some seriousness. Again she has, you know, removed her spectacles. Again she wiped it. Again she has looked at very, you know, serious way. And then she put them again on her, and again she looked at the class. When she spoke, her voice was very low because she also got hurt. Because one of her student is not there in the class because of the ill treatment given by her own students. That is why whatever she said next, was her voice was very low. I am sure that none of the boys and girls in the room 13 would purposely and deliberately hurt anyone's feeling because his or her name happened to be a long unfamiliar one. So she had guaranteed in a different way that whatever you have done here, it is not deliberately done act. It might be because of the you haven't thought much on that. That is why, because you know better that if you will do that, you will be not good one. Your name will not be in the famous people's name, or you will not be popular among the students. So this fact you know. That is why it is thoughtful, you know, thoughtlessness act. This act, it is not deliberately done. It is by mistake you have committed this mistake. It might be like that. Miss Mason has said, I prefer to think that what was said in the thoughtlessness. What she said, what was said to Wanda Petrowski was only a matter of thoughtlessness. You haven't thought anymore and you said and said. I know that all of you feel the way I do, that this is a very unfortunate thing to have happened, unfortunate and sad both. So she knew her preaching, she knew her how she had guided you all. So she said that it is whatever happened, it happened, but it is unfortunate because this should not happen, unfortunate thing it is, and it is very sad also because of that Wanda Petrowski, who was a very good artist, is not coming in our school now. She has left the school because she got hurt. She hasn't got good treatment in your class. That is why. So it is unfortunate and sad as well. And I want you all to think about it. Why she said like that? Because she wants that none. This should not be happen again and again in the class. One should take care of the feeling of the others as we are human being. The first period was a study period. Mary tried to prepare her lesson, but she could not put her mind on her work. And you know that better that even Mary was there supporting Peggy, not exactly supporting, but when Peggy used to ask the question to the Wanda, how many dresses you have that time, Mary also didn't like that question. But see why she stopped herself, because she thought that suppose I will stop Peggy, maybe I am the next victim. I will be the next victim of Peggy. So because the condition of Wanda and Maddie was similar. Both belong to very poor family. And that is why she didn't say. So now she understood that she could have stopped Peggy by doing so to hurting Vanda. Now then Vanda would have been in the class. So that guilt she was getting, that guilt she was suffering from, and that is why she couldn't concentrate in her studies. She had a very sick feeling in the bottom of her stomach. True, she had not enjoyed listening to Peggy ask Vanda how many dresses she had in her closet, but she had said nothing. Now she remembered everything. She never enjoyed that when Peggy asked Vanda how many dresses you have, but she said nothing. That was the guilt. That was the thing which was tortured her, which was torturing her also. She had stood by silently, and that was just as bad as what Peggy has done. So Peggy had bullied her. She had said nothing. It means it is a similar kind of crime, according to Maddie, and it is right one. Suppose we see any crime is happening in front of eyes, and the person who is a criminal who is acting that is a culprit surely, but the person who is wise but looking at that by folding his or her hand, it also is also similar kind of culprit. So similar kind of idea she has now, understanding who Maddie, and that is why. Now she was called. At least Peggy hadn't considered they were being mean, but she, Maddie, had thought they were doing wrong. She could put herself in the vendor's shoes. If Maddie would have put herself in the vendor's shoes, she might have understood the feeling of Vanda, how she would have felt when Peggy was teasing her. So she said herself very coward. She was coward. Even though Peggy was doing that, she doesn't know what exactly she was doing. But Maddie at least knew very well what it was wrong. And she never put her, you know, feet in the shoes of Vanda. Goodness, wasn't there anything she could do? If only she could tell Vanda she hadn't meant to hurt her feelings. Now, you know, water has passed away under the bridge. Now she could do nothing, but she can tell, she can meet Vanda and tell that I really didn't want to hurt you anymore. It was totally, you know, thoughtlessness process or thoughtlessness act. Without thinking, the act was, you know, proceeded. She turned around and stole a glance at Peggy, but Peggy did not look up. Now she was thinking, after the reading of the letter by the Mason, Miss Mason, she was not at all in the studies. She was thinking about Vanda. And she was thinking, and for a moment she has looked at the Peggy, but Peggy was not looking at her. It means that by this we can understand Peggy was not that sentimental girl like Maddie. Maddie was thinking that I did something wrong. I did support Peggy, that is why Vanda got hurt. Suppose anyone who stood against Peggy, she would have got little courage to fight with those all students, those who were making bullying on Vanda. But nobody had come forward to help Vanda that time. And so Vanda has left the school. But Peggy did not look up. She seemed to be studying hard. Well, whether Peggy felt bad or not, she, Maddie, had to do something. Now this is the matter of the sentiments. If I feel something wrong which I had done, I should go further to say excuse, to ask for the excuse, to apologize to someone else whom I am the, whom I have made to cry, to whom I have hurt. Maddie had to do something. She had to find Vanda Petronsky. Maybe she had not yet moved away. Maybe Peggy would climb the height with her, and they would tell Vanda she had won the contest, and they thought she was smart and 100 dresses were beautiful. Now, you know that suppose we did something which is really very wrong, and suppose we want to make amends of that, means to, you know, to say, to express that we are really very sorry for whatever we have done earlier. So they wanted to meet both. Missy wanted to take Peggy to meet Vanda and to tell them that, tell Vanda that you are really fabulous, you have done extraordinary well, you have drawn hundreds of great pictures, and we are proud of you, we are proud of you. And that when a school was dismissed in the afternoon, Peggy said with the pretended casualness, means to show indifference, means okay, I feel like that. we pretended, we're showing that I have a little casualness. Hey, let's go and see if that kid has left town or not. That kid, it's a very, you know, disgusting language which Peggy has done. Even Sif didn't feel guilty about whatever she had done. Because of Peggy, Wanda has left the school. But still, what she said, hey, let's go and see if that kid has left town or not. So this was disgusting. So Peggy had the same idea, Maddie glowed. But in a nutshell, we can understand, even she showed that nothing had happened to her, Peggy. She is not that bothered about what she has done with the Wanda Petrowski. But she had certain ideas. She was also thinking about the Wanda. It means she was feeling that she did something wrong with the Wanda. So Peggy had some same idea, Maddie glowed, and that is why Maddie becomes so happy. Okay, I have a similar idea, she has also. So we will go together. Peg was really alright. The two girls hurried out of the building, up the street toward the Boggins side where Wanda was living. The part of town that wore such a forbidding air on this kind of the November afternoon. It was very wet land, not so hygienically well. It was not the society of the sophisticated people. Here on the kinds of the November afternoon, drizzly, damp and dismal. Dismal means wet and very sad. It was not a good area to live for the kids. But she was living, because she was belonged to a very poor family. She was living in poverty. Well, at least said Piggy gruffly, I never did call her foreigner or make fun of her name. I never thought she had the sense to know we were making fun of her anyway. And she said she wanted to justify her act by saying that I never hurt her. I never taunt her for her funny name. But only just I thought that if I will ask the question, she will not understand this, because I thought she is little dumb. She doesn't have any kind of feelings, or she will not understand that we are making fun of her. I thought like that. Who said? Peggy said. I thought she was too dumb, and look how she can draw. And just see how hundreds of pictures in an extremely well manner she has drawn. Maddie could say nothing because she didn't agree with the statement. Whatever Peggy has said, she didn't agree with the statement. All she hoped that was that they would find Wanda. She wanted to tell her that they were sorry they had picked on her. They criticized her. Picked on her means what? Criticized her. They wanted to go there. She doesn't want to listen anything of any kind of thing from the Peggy. Only one thing she wanted to do, that she wanted to ask for the sorry. She wanted to ask for the apology. And how wonderful the whole world thought she was, and please not to move away, and everybody would be nice. She had a Peggy would fight anybody who was not nice, and both wanted, Miss Maddie wanted to give the assurance to Wanda, please don't go. Now everybody will be very nice to you. They will give very smart treatment, very nice treatment, very honorable treatment to you. Don't go. And suppose anyone will come and tease you something, we will come. We'll stand against them and we'll protect you. So that's what they wanted to say. The two girls hurried on. They hoped to get to the top of the hill before dark, because they were very small kids, not younger, elder ones. So they don't have that boldness to come back again before sunset. So I think that's where the Petronskis live, said Maddie, pointing to the little white house. Just see, by this particular setting we can understand the class of the people, because she was very poor, and poor people will not live in a luxurious area of the society, right? That is why. Whips of the old grass stuck up there and there along the pathway like thin kittens. The house and its sparse little yard looked shabby but clean. It was not too decorated. It was not that luxurious. It was not the decoration like of the rich people, but it was very clean. That was the main point. It was very clean. It was very clean means by this we can understand the hard working of those people. Okay. It reminded Maddie of Wanda's one dress, her faded blue cotton dress, shabby but clean. By the dress also, we can understand Vanda was very poor, but she was hard worker. She was very absolutely fine girl. How we can understand? By her dress was faded, very old, but it was very clean. By this we can understand she was very hard worker and very honest girl. There was not a sign of life about the house. What was the sign of life exactly? Means nobody was there. We didn't understand any movement or any talkings of the people around the house. So baby knocked firmly on the door, but there was no answer. See, and Maddie went round to the black yard and knocked there. Still there was no answer. But we can understand that no one was there. There was no doubt about it. The patron's keys were gone. How could they ever make amends? Now they have lost the chance to ask for the apology. They were not there. Now how can they meet a patron's keys? How they will make amends? How they will ask for the apology? They turned slowly and made their way back down the hill. Well, anyway, said Peggy, she's gone now. So what can we do? Besides, when I was asking her about all her dresses, she probably was getting good ideas for her drawings. She might not even have won the contest otherwise. And again she wanted to justify her act. She said that if I would not have asked her about how many dresses you have, she might not have got the ideas for the sketching the new dresses. And probably she would not have won the crown contest. So Peggy wanted to try to clear the justify look about it. Mary turned this idea carefully over in her head, for if there were anything in it, she would not have to feel so badly. But that night she could not get to sleep. She thought about Vanda and her faded blue dress and the little house she had lived in. And she thought of the glowing picture those 100 dresses made, all lined up in the classroom. At last, Maddie sat up in the bed and pressed her forehead tight in her hand and really thought this was the hardest thinking she had ever done. After a long time, she reached an important conclusion. She was never going to stand by and say nothing again. So we have understood that they went there, but they didn't meet Vanda. Again, while coming, Peggy said that because of her, she got the ideas to draw 100 dresses. But Mary didn't pay attention toward the Peggy. And then she recalled all the memories, all the dresses, her faded dresses and all. And she was not getting a sound sleep because she was thinking about Vanda. Then she has firmly said to herself, now anymore I will not tease anyone, not even I will stand with anyone who is teasing. I will stand against the person who will tease anyone. Like that she has determined. If she ever heard about picking on someone because they are funny looking or because they had strange names, she would speak up even if it mean losing Peggy's friendship. Now she had determined. She became so determined, she fixed her goal that she said if someone is teasing by someone's name, funny names or her class and everyone, but I will not at all tolerate that. Even it will cost me the friendship with Peggy. If Peggy will leave me, she will break the friendship no matter, but I will not assist. I will not take the side of the wrong people, she said. She had no way of making things right with Vanda, but from now on, she would never make anybody else that unhappy again. And she has decided, I will not make anyone unhappy again in my whole life. Now we'll see the next part of the lesson. On Saturday, Maddie spent the whole afternoon with the Peggy. They were writing a letter to Vanda Petronsky. It was just a friendly letter telling about the contest and telling Vanda she had won. They told her how pretty her drawings were and they asked her if she liked where she was living and if she liked her new teacher. They had meant to say they were sorry. But it ended up with just writing a very friendly letter. The kind of the kind they would have written to any good friend, and they sign it with the lots of love, Miss X for love. They mailed a letter to Bogginside, writing, please forward on the envelope. And then both were busy to write one later because they couldn't meet Wanda Petrowski, but they wanted to ask for the apology. So they wanted to write one later, and they have written, started with the very, you know, very friendly letter. They have written in that letter how they think about her, that she had won the contest and everything. They have made it very, how is your new teacher, how is that school, everything. See, they have written in the letter. And at the end, they have written lots of love with the form of X. They have written X means lots of love, means many number of X they have written by, to show her that we loved you a lot. We loved you a lot. Days pass and there was no answer. And one more thing I missed to tell you that here, that they have post that letter to the Bogginside, writing, please forward to the envelope. Means actually they didn't know the address of Wanda Petrowski, where actually the family had gone. So they have written that please forward the envelope, because that particular post office might have got the correct address of the Wanda Petrowski. So they will write down the Petrowski's address, so it will reach the Petrowski. Days pass and there was no answer, but the letter did not come back. So maybe Wanda had received it. You know that suppose any letter will not receive anyone, then it will come back to the sender. So that letter didn't come back. So it means surely it was reached to the Wanda Petrowski. But later the answer was not got. Perhaps she was so hurt and angry, she was not going to answer. You could not blame her. Already she got hurt, that is why she left the school. And if she had not written the answer, we should not blame her, because it was a right. Because she might have heard a lot, and that is why she didn't write the answer. So it was, she was right at her side. Maybe time will go and she might give the answer. Weeks went by and still Wanda did not answer. Peggy had begun to forget the whole business, and Maddie put herself to sleep at night making speeches about Wanda. So whole scenario of the class, whole scenario of the lesson, we have understood that Peggy was not that sentimental girl. She doesn't have that sentiments which Maddie has, because Maddie belongs to a very poor family. She knows what are the things she was facing and what were the things Wanda was facing. So she was, both were traveling in a similar boat, only she had got assistance of Peggy and she didn't. Understood? So Maddie was right in her thinking how Wanda was troubled when she was in the school. So Maddie didn't sleep. She used to make speeches for the Wanda, that I will say like that, I will say like that, I will say, I will admit my fault, I will admit my guilt to Wanda Petrowski. Again, she was thinking that when there will be crowds and they will be teasing Wanda Petrowski, I will say, don't do that. So suddenly she used to admit that, she imagined that, and she used to scream with that. Peggy had begun to forget her whole business, and Maddie put herself to sleep at night making speeches about Wanda, defending her from the great crowd of the girls who were trying to tease with her, how many dresses have you got? And before Wanda could raise her lips to get in the light time, see the way she did before answering, Maddie would cry out, stop. Then everybody would feel ashamed the way the she used to feel. And then before doing that, Maddie will shout out or shout at all the students that don't do that, stop it, and they all will become ashamed and they will go away. Like that she was imagining, because totally she was engrossed with the thought of that I did something wrong with one of the girl, one of my classmates, that is Wanda Petrowski, and until and unless I will not meet her, I will not find any good way. I will not find any sound sleep also. Now it was Christmas time and there was snow on the ground. Christmas bells and small tree decorated the classroom. On the last day of the school before the holiday, the teacher showed the class a letter she had received that morning. You know that when Diwali is there, we see that everywhere there is a lantern, then crackers, and then everywhere there is, you know, that particular atmosphere. Like that, it was a Christmas atmosphere. Christmas is a great celebration in the foreign countries, and that is why everywhere there is a, you know, surrounding of the Christmas festival celebration, and small trees, decorated classroom on the last day. And before a holiday, Miss Mason has told the class, I have something to show you, that I have a letter for the class that I am going to read for you. You remember Vanda Petronsky, the gifted little artist who won the drawing contest? Well, she has written me, and I am glad to know where she lives. Now, by this statement, we can understand that days, many days have passed. That is why she asked the question to whole class, do you know your classmate Vanda Petronsky? Today morning, I have received one letter from her. Now I am very glad because I understood her address. Now I can send her the medal she has won in the drawing contest. Okay. I want to read her letter to you. The class sat up with a sudden interest and listened very intently because they wanted to understand the reaction of the Vanda, how she was thinking about the whole class. Was she hurt? Was she angry with her? Like that, they were wanted to understand. Dear Miss Mason, because his letter was written to class teacher. How are you and room number 13? Please tell the girls they can keep those 100 dresses, because in my new house, I have 100 new ones all lined up in my closet. So, just see how great she was. She hasn't told dad, okay, I have left the school, so please give me my all pictures. I want to keep it for my memory. What she said? Just give all my 100 pictures to all my classmates. She was a very great-hearted girl, you can understand. So again, it was a great work, great stem from the Vanda Petronsky. She hadn't snatched anything. She hadn't snatched the happiness of others. She had given something. She had given the happiness. To give something to someone means to give the happiness. Even though her happiness was stolen, snatched by all the classmates of the room number 13, but she hadn't said anything. Only she kept mum, she left the school, but she hadn't said anything to those girls. Even maybe she might have written that those students have tortured me and all, so I am not happy with them, I don't want to talk with them, I don't want to think about them. They didn't say, she didn't say like this. What she said, I am really missing them, and I wanted to give all my 100 pictures to all the classmates. Just see the greatness of that Vanda Petronsky. I have 100 new dresses, one all line in my closet. I would like that girl Peggy to have the drawing of green dress with the red trimming. And she has absolutely fine picture for Peggy. And she has only made for her, because she has properly acknowledged that picture, that green picture which have red trimming, and her friend Maddie to have the blue one. She does mention there Peggy's friend Maddie. Okay, so here also we can understand, she might, Vanda Petronsky might have understood Maddie was her friend, that is why she couldn't stand against her. Okay, so that was, we can understand here, even Maddie was thinking that she was not good because she hadn't stopped against her. But might have Vanda Petronsky said Peggy's friend Maddie. So if Maddie is a Peggy's friend, how she will react against Maggie, Peggy? So here we can understand, we can conclude like that. She hadn't said that Maddie directly. She said Peggy's friend Maddie. It means if Maddie is the friend of Peggy, so Maddie will not say anything wrong about Peggy. So that is why, means here we can understand how she has justified the her silence. Whose silence? Maddie's silence. Vanda Petronsky. So by this we can understand Petronsky. Vanda Petronsky was a very great girl in the class. And what she said? Give her blue one for Christmas. I miss that school, and my new teacher does not equalize with you. Merry Christmas to you and everybody. And she said again, I miss you all, and my new teacher is not like you, Miss Mason. You are great. And there is not a single teacher who can match up you.
And again at the end he wishes all of them Merry Christmas. He was truly Vanda Petronsky. It was a very great letter which was written by Vanda Petronsky to Miss Mason and whole class. So there was not a single utterance of that she was totally hurt, she was not with them like that. She showed her love toward the class. On the way home from the school, Maddie and Peggy held their drawings very carefully because that was a gift. That was a gift by Vanda Petronsky. All the houses had faith and holy in the windows. Outside the grocery store, hundreds of Christmas trees were stacked, and in the window, candy, peppermint stick, and cornucopias of shiny transparent paper were strung. Now this is the atmosphere of the Christmas, so that surroundings has been described here. The air smelled like the Christmas, and lights shining everywhere reflected different colors of the snow. "Boy," said Peggy, "be sure she really likes us." So she had deliberately given, only she had chosen both of us. A special picture she has announced to give to Peggy and Maddie. It means she did like us. Who said? Peggy said. It means she didn't hurt. She liked me and you. So, okay. It shows she got outer later, and this is her way of saying that everything is all right. And that's that. "I hope so," said Maddie sadly. "Okay, maybe," I said. "It may be like that. I hope so." But it was the energy in the sentence was not that good. She felt sad because she knew that she would never see the little tight-lipped polished girl again, and couldn't even really make things right between them. She was very sorrowful. Maddie was very sorrowful. She was very disappointed because she thought that she will never see that girl again, that Polish girl again, Miss Vanda Petronsky again. And she will not make amends, there will not be any clearance about that. She was not wrong, Peggy was wrong, and I was the friend of Peggy, that is why I couldn't say anything. She couldn't manage that. She went home and she pinned her drawings over the torn place in the pink flowered wallpaper in the bedroom. Just see again, the picture of Vanda Petronsky had decorated the house where there was one patch. There only she had stuck the picture, by which we can understand again, Vanda Petronsky had helped the Maddie. So by this we can understand Vanda Petronsky had given only to Maddie and all her classmates. Now room was not looking so fine because one patch was there, and where when Maddie has put that picture of the dress which is given by Vanda Petronsky, then that room looked so beautiful. The shabby room came alive from the brilliance of the color. Maddie sat down on her bed and looked at the drawing. She had stood by and said nothing, but Vanda had been nice to her anyway. Tears blurred her eyes, and she gazed for a long time at the picture because she was remembering, she was recollecting all the memories what she had done with a very wonderful girl. Then hastily she rubbed her eyes and studied it intently. Very closely she has studied the picture of Vanda Petronsky, which was gifted by Vanda Petronsky. The colors in the tree dresses were so vivid, and she had scarcely noticed the face and head of the drawing. But it looked like her, Maddie. It really looked like her own mouth. Why it really looked like her own self? Vanda had really drawn this off her. Excitedly she ran over the pages, and she was totally engrossed with the thought of the Vanda Petronsky. She was thinking that I did something wrong. And she was just engrossed in the color of the picture. She was looking very closely at the picture. And suddenly she understood that picture is looking like me. Yes, exactly. This picture is of Maddie. This picture is of nothing but Maddie. So she ran towards the Peggy because she have certain suspect, doubt, that picture which was given to Peggy also will be the pictures of Peggy, which was drawn by Vanda Petronsky. "Look, she drew you, that's you," she exclaimed, and the head and the face of this picture did look like Peggy. "What did I say?" said Peggy. "She must have really liked us anyway." Just see. Was that reality? That Wanda Petrovsky liked Peggy, that is why she had given picture? No, she wanted to know that don't hurt others, because all are good, all are behaving good. But she said she has taken it very normally, even though Wanda had given Peggy her picture. She said, yes. Why she had given? Because she liked us very much. It is also a good thing. Yes, she must have, agreed Maddie, and she blinked away the tears that came every time she thought of Wanda standing alone and in the sunny spot in the schoolyard, looking solidly over the group of laughing girls about after she had walked off, after she had said, sure, 100 of them all line up. And again, at the end again, Wanda had given dresses, pictures of dresses to Peggy and Maddie. So the thought of the Wanda never given rest to Maddie. She always engrossed with the thought of Wanda Petrovsky. So this is the lesson which we have learned today. Exactly what we have to learn in this, through this lesson, that we should not hurt others. Because all the people, all the, you know, our classmates are very good, and if we hurt them, they might get, you know, hurt, and they might become so sad, they might stop whatever they are doing good. If Peggy and Maddie would have behaved very well with the Wanda Petrovsky, she would have been there, and she would have good education in with them. So we have to think about that everybody has heart, and we need to care of everybody's heart, because we have to behave with the others the way we want others should behave with us. On this note, I would say this lesson is over. Thank you very much.